On the 20th of April, 1889, a boy was born in an Austrian village. He would go on to lead a nation to the brink of destruction and leave Europe in ruins. As one of history's most brutal dictators, he would be responsible for the deaths of millions. This is the story of Adolf Hitler. The fourth child of Clara and Alois, Adolf Hitler was loved by an indulgent mother and beaten by a strict father. After a turbulent childhood, Hitler travelled to Vienna, where he hoped to attend the Academy of Fine Arts, but the college turned him down, and by 1908, he was completely broke. He often had to take refuge in some of the Jewish-funded homeless shelters. At the outbreak of the First World War, Hitler joined the army. He was awarded two Iron Crosses for bravery and promoted, but his superiors thought that he lacked the leadership qualities needed to achieve a high rank. On the 9th of November 1918, the Kaiser, Germany's royal leader, gave up his throne and Germany became a republic. The new government signed the Versailles Treaty, the document drawn up by the Allies to officially end the war. Hitler and most Germans felt humiliated by the treaty, which insisted that Germany pay money to the Allies and give up its army and overseas territories. Soon after the war ended, Hitler joined the right-wing German Workers' Party, turning them into a proper political party and changing their name to the National Socialist German Workers' Party, or Nazi Party. In November 1923, Hitler tried to overthrow the government by force. His coup failed and he was jailed. During his year in prison, Hitler dictated Mein Kampf, My Struggle, to his chauffeur. Partly autobiographical, the book's real purpose was to condemn the Jews and the communists who Hitler believed were responsible for Germany's many problems. Hitler understood that the German people longed for the days when Germany had been prosperous and united. He knew they wanted a strong leader, not a democratic one. At the 1932 elections, the Nazis failed to win control of parliament, but a group of businessmen persuaded President Hindenburg to make Hitler chancellor in 1933. Hitler immediately banned all opposition, and Germany became a one-party state. Thousands of Hitler's political opponents were arrested and sent to the recently opened concentration camps. President Hindenburg's death in 1934 gave Hitler total power. He set about creating a mighty army and stirring the German people into a frenzy of nationalism. Huge rallies were organized at which Hitler pronounced his political philosophy. The Germans, the ancient Aryan race, were superior to all others. They had a duty to control the world and would have to do so by force. Racial purity was the only way to ensure total domination. Unnoticed by the outside world, anyone not conforming to Hitler's idealized vision was removed from public life. The mentally and physically handicapped, homosexuals, gypsies, and Jews were top of the hit list. Hitler inflamed anti-Jewish feeling, so that it became impossible for Jews to live and work in German society. After encouraging mass emigration, the remaining Jews began to be rounded up and taken to the ever-growing concentration camps. Hitler ordered his troops into Austria and the Sudetenland in 1938. Encouraged by a lack of international opposition, he then invaded Poland on the 1st of September 1939. Britain and France declared war on Germany, but still nation after nation fell to the Nazi war machine. Fueled by a growing delusional confidence, Hitler invaded his former ally Russia in 1941. It was a fateful decision. Early victories were reversed with crushing defeats. America's entry into the war in December 1941 meant that Hitler's army was fighting two heavyweight nations and the British Empire at the same time. In 1944, the Western Allies invaded Europe. Undeterred, Hitler ordered his army and his people to fight to the death to defend the fatherland. By April 1945, Germany had been brought to its knees. With the noose tightening and his retreating army fighting on two fronts, Hitler committed suicide in the ruins of Berlin. A few days later, the Second World War was over, but Hitler's legacy was to dominate the 20th century. The war he had started had killed more than 56 million people. Among them were over 6 million Jews.